Today, we will classify two-dimensional figures using geometric attributes or characteristics. These figures are flat, closed figures with only two dimensions, length and width. Let's begin with a review of the vocabulary words that we will use today. Quadrilateral, a polygon with four sides, four vertices, and four angles. Parallel lines, lines that are always the same distance apart and will never intersect. Perpendicular lines, a special type of intersecting line where a right angle is formed at the point of intersection. Right angle, an angle that forms a square corner 90 degrees. The two-dimensional figures we will use today are quadrilaterals, figures that have four sides, four vertices, and four angles. Square, rhombus, isosceles trapezoid, rectangle, parallelogram, right trapezoid. We will use the following graphic organizer to identify the attributes of these figures based on the lines and angles they have. As we mentioned before, all the figures are quadrilaterals because they have four sides, four vertices, and four angles. We will check the column four sides for all these figures. Now let's count the number of parallel sides each figure has. Square, one pair of parallel sides, two pair of parallel sides. Rhombus, one pair of parallel sides, two pair of parallel sides. Isosceles trapezoid, one pair of parallel sides. Rectangle, one pair of parallel sides, two pair of parallel sides. Parallelogram, one pair of parallel sides, two pair of parallel sides. Right trapezoid, one pair of parallel sides. Let's record this information in our graphic organizer. Now let's analyze if our figures have perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines will form right angles when they intersect. Square. All the sides, when they intersect, form perpendicular lines and right angles. Rhombus. It does not have perpendicular lines nor right angles. Isosceles trapezoid. It does not have perpendicular lines nor right angles. Rectangle. All the sides when they intersect form perpendicular lines and right angles. Parallelogram. It does not have perpendicular lines nor right angles. Right trapezoid. This figure does have some perpendicular lines, but not all the lines are perpendicular. Let's record this information in our graphic organizer. Now, let's analyze if the opposite sides and angles of the figures are congruent or have the same size. Square. Top and bottom sides are congruent, and left and right sides are congruent. We can see that all the sides are the same size. Therefore, all sides are congruent. Rhombus. Opposite sides are congruent, and all the sides are the same size. Therefore, all sides are congruent. Isosceles trapezoid. Top and bottom sides are not congruent. Only the left and right sides are congruent. Rectangle. Top and bottom sides are congruent, and left and right sides are congruent. Parallelogram. Top and bottom sides are congruent, and left and right sides are congruent. Right trapezoid. None of the sides are congruent. Let's record this information in our graphic organizer. Using the graphic organizer that we created, we can classify the two-dimensional figures as follows. All the figures have four sides, therefore they are quadrilaterals. Then we can see that some figures have only one pair of parallel lines, and others have two pairs of parallel and congruent lines. The parallelograms now can be classified in figures with or without four right angles. Something that we can observe is that both the rhombus and the square have all four sides congruent, so we can also categorize our figures like this. In this lesson, we classified two-dimensional figures using the attributes based on their lines and angles. Can you find a two-dimensional figure and classify it using the attributes we learned today?